Comrades, it is always an inspiration to stand before ex-combatants and have frank discussions about our plans, our challenges, and how together we aim to resolve the bottlenecks and ensure that ultimately the needs of military veterans are resolved. We must point out that we have embarked on these roadshows to get first-hand information from military veterans and in turn give first-hand information about how we seek to resolve issues of your benefits. Today, we are ex-combatants and we still believe the very principles and values which motivated us then should still motivate us today. On Thursday, in the cabinet meeting, the Minister of Defense and Military Veterans, Minister Nosiviwe Maphisa-Ntlakula, motivated for a very big project, which is in the Defense Force, not to go to the private sector, but to go to the military veterans. And that project was withdrawn by the cabinet, and it must now come to military veterans. I don't know those comrades of MK who know Comrade Jabu magazine. They are owning a farm in Cape Town, I saw it, of apples, and it is doing well. So don't look at the tenders, comrades, and read at tenders every day. It's not going to assist. Look at this thing of agriculture, it's very important, because we will assist you to have offtake with other institutions. We have also committed ourselves to health and wellness to ensure that military veterans are looked after, given their health challenges and the effects of the past, which have manifested into post-traumatic stress. In this area, we're exploring the possibility of private sector support to establish a medical aid structure tailored for the needs of military veterans and their dependents. We're going to have a medical aid scheme. Again, you have this cards of one military hospital, which do not cover your dependents. But sometimes people are staying far from these hospitals. They die in the process, which is a reality, because they can't access 1 meal, 2 meal, or 3 meal. Now, that scheme, you are going to be able to go to a general practitioner, not you alone, but with your dependents. So, again, there are those comrades who are receiving special pension. Maybe Rantla will correct me if I'm lying here. But I read that policy. Even yesterday I read it. To say, if you are receiving special pension, you are a military veteran, but you receive 2,000 rand. The department, this pension, it is going to top up for you also to be at the bracket of 3,500. That is why I've brought the department here. Decision-making body people. I don't bring people who go to consult. They are here to take decisions and say, Monday, this thing will be done. Siyaqhuba. Ziyalunga into zamakhomanda.